Hey, Moon Platoon, you probably have questions about the NSCC, like, where is my money, Lebowski? Or is NSCC 2021-002 the end of all shorts? And finally, you've been here for 2 minutes and you're already subscribing? Thanks. Grizzly Giant, I am here to answer all of your questions, including George V's. Can you explain 002 for the apes that missed it? We are currently on the precipice of something huge, right? Something pretty significant. A camera change. Cool. And now we're also in looking at the approved 002 NSCC 2021 is now hereby approved on an accelerated basis. What exactly does that mean? Well, we have the document here, including some annotations about exactly why the DTCC is doing this right now after talking about it for months. We also have to talk about the options chain and whether the deep in the money calls have finally ended and what that means for the upcoming day of trading tomorrow and for the week of trading coming on. If you guys like this video, if you find some value out of it, remember, we are going up to 3,000 videos, 3,000 likes on these videos nowadays, so make sure to smash it, comment out which like you are to defeat that algorithm together, and here we go. DTCC, June 21st, 2021. Let's highlight that part. And let's highlight the effective date of the proposed changes will be Wednesday, June 23rd, 2021. This is right now the end and most important piece that I'm going to put right in front of you. If this is effective by the DTCC, that does not necessarily mean that the SEC is going to accept it as the law, right? It means that the DTCC members have now created a brand new rule for its country club, the country club or cartel, if you want to call it, of the biggest money holders in the world, or at the very least in the American system. So now that you're talking about whether or not the DTCC is going to give you a break for the risky benefits that possibly defaulting members of the DTCC will have to either make a serious fine, something that we're going to call a supplemental liquidity deposit every single day, or face an automatic margin call on the daily, or something even more sinister. And this comes down to this big bucket of money. I hate pie charts, and yet I keep drawing them on my dashboards here. We have the amount of money by the DTCC as a pie chart, and now we are separating that based on boring funds, right? Like bonds and very secure, low interest, low growth opportunities for investment, and then risky ones, such as shorting a stock to the ends of the earth just to try and bankrupt a stock, like it has worked many, many times before. In fact, by the end of this video, if you stay to the end, we're going to talk about whether or not Jim Cramer has been calling it since 2006, as early as the beginning of these first 2008 financial crisis, and now soon coming 2021 financial crisis, maybe already ongoing if you've taken a look at the market and the crypto markets today. All right. DTCC is saying three parts of this filing, which I have labeled as money, math, hold on, money, math, and margin calls. Maybe not in exactly that order. First thing with money, calculating and collecting, when applicable, a SLD. That stands for a supplemental liquidity deposit. Don't let it confuse you before it throws you off, right? A supplementary liquidity deposit is just a fine or a consequence of making risky bets. The risky portfolio of the DTCC can put it into major trouble when it comes down to whether or not they can afford to continue making those risky bets, such as betting against AMC and GME. So we've seen the infinite stock glitch, right? Let's say that infinite stock glitch of using naked shorts and then cycling them through deep in the money calls, which is going to be what we're going to analyze in the end of the video with the options chain. That practice is like getting infinite sodas from the soda machine down the road, right? Everyone's been using it. Every financial crash has been in part due to these glitches that you find in the system. But so far, you're a kid on the block and you like free soda. Well, a bigger kid, in fact, a collection of kids called the DTCC have started to impose a fine. If you go and continue trying to get free sodas from this glitch, the infinite stock glitch, the infinite short glitch, you will now every day have someone come to your house and ask you whether or not you have too many illicit investments, too many free sodas inside your apartment. If you do, well, they are going to calculate an SLD for your risk portfolio and then charge you based on here's the math, observed member activity rather than historical and forecasted. This is just a change in how they've originally calculated that math, but the difference is that it is different, right? That's the most important piece, is that now whatever algorithm or whatever projection that they were using to try and understand whether or not they're still in the clear by taking these risky bets, they have to now redo all of that math because the math has now changed. Make that math make sense, by the way, if this light counter isn't all the way up to 3K. The third point is adopting an intraday SLD calculation based around monthly option settlement periods, as well as additional exposures presented by options activity. So now we're talking about options as a more important piece of the calculation of that math. And that's why we are now going to talk about the speculation of those deep in the money calls. So the DTCC, taking into consideration that they don't want to lose this red part of their portfolio because it is getting too risky, has now internalized an externality of the kids beating up the vending machine that gives them free soda. Now, at any point, any day, they could face an automatic margin call and have 1 hour to come up with the funds needed to match the SLD that they are being fined with. Okay, we understand that. Well, what can we take a look at when it comes down to this option chain here? As of course, this is Option Sonar. If you wanted to use your own, go ahead in the description down below and you'll find a link to Option Sonar. Originally, a few weeks ago, we were seeing nonstop deep in the money calls, which we still see a little bit of, but it is being overshadowed by major battlegrounds at $70, $60, and even constantly every day at $145 at the far right side of the potential gamma squeeze. Let's take a look as early as 11th when we started learning about 005 and its possible implications. We started seeing these this serious collection of deep in the money calls, $25 million here at 43, right? $11 million here at 40. These are earmarked, right? The speculation behind these is that they are earmarked for a market maker like Citadel and a short hedge fund like Belvin to trade them back and forth, right? Even Citadel could do it with another market maker and create synthetic longs that then transfer into a brand new due date for potential FTDs, failure to delivers. We've covered this analysis a couple of times, but the main thing to pay attention to is that we've had tens of millions of calls in the money all the way up until the 18th, right? This is the last one with $16 million worth of calls at 40 bucks. And now today, bubkiss, right? We only have about 3 million at 40, 2 million at 35, and 3 million at 30, right? So this is a great change based around whether or not the options chain math is going to be profitable or even possible for the hedge funds to continue shorting the stock, right? Is the naked short entirely dead? Well, it's starting to seem like that they're behavior is changing. So let me loop it all the way back around to Jim, because he is going to give you a pretty clear understanding of what this entire process is all about. Truth. It's about creating a perception inside your audience
of what's really going on under the market that you don't see.
Right, nobody else talks about it.
Right, but what's important when you're in that hedge fund mode is to not do anything remotely truthful. Because the truth is so against your view,
right,
that it's important to create a new truth.
The truth is so against your view that it's important to create a new truth. So with the positive catalyst that we've seen today, right, GameStop appointing its new CEO, with the old CEO getting kicked to the curb, even off of the board of directors, and AMC facing 400,000 calls that have been in the money on Friday and having today and tomorrow to exercise. If you remember your call that is in the money right now from last Friday, quadruple witching day, and you haven't exercised yet, remember, it's your democratic duty to play around with the options chain when your calls are in the money. And finally, AMC hitting the proverbial stride with a $63 high today, and now a $10 difference down to $53.43. It's the perception that the hedge funds want you to see. They want to create a sense of panic and a sense that even on Wednesday, nothing is going to happen. I wanted to be able to emphasize again, I told you the most important piece of FUD that you can read is that Wednesday, everything is over, right? And it might appear so from this this bolded underlined statement that the effective date of the proposed changes will be Wednesday. However, the SEC is an important player, and we need to see what they say about this regulation for it to truly take effect. Hopefully this video was a good one. Hopefully this video gave you the explanation that you were looking for. John DeSova is a mod and explains it very simply in this way as well. For the more technical minded ones out there, 002 means a provider will be obligated to provide an SLD, supplementary liquidity deposit, on each business day in which its settlement activity causes a liquidity shortfall at the NSCC. NSCC will then provide a notice to each provider of the amount of its supplemental liquidity deposit, which the provider will be requested to fund within 1 hour of such notice. So now you've seen the technical side, you've seen the three bullet points that the DTCC would like you to read, and now you've also smashed that like and that subscribe. It's important because we are currently on a battle of perception, just like Jim Cramer said. It's more about how many apes and how many Moon Platoon members out there can see the sleeping meatball and say, yes, now I actually understand how the markets work. Investing in yourself is the first step of your financial journey. And so if you guys want financial freedom and continuing learning with me and Professor Meatball, the easiest way is to hit that subscribe. And then the next step, hitting that join button so you can show up here on the Moon Platoon, Meatball of Space Legend tier, and the Guerrillionaire tier. And we'll see all of you in the money. Peace.